Good evening and welcome to News 24. This is Tamima Islam with the top news of the day. Prime Minister Sheikh Hasina said that the conspirators could not isolate Bangabandhu from the public by spreading massive propaganda and rumours, and that is why he was murdered. Speaking at a discussion on the occasion of National Mourning Day, Sheikh Hasina further said that the purpose of the murder was to destroy the spirit of the Liberation War. The Premier added Zia-ur Rahman killed about 2,000 freedom fighters after 15th August for the same reason. She also blamed Khalida Zia for playing a similar role when the August 21st, 2004 grenade attack was carried out. Bangabandhu's birth centenary celebration, National Implementation Committee organized the discussion at the International Mother Language Institute, while the Premier joined it from her official residence Ganabhavan through a video conference on Sunday. The Appellate Division of the Supreme Court has upheld the order of the High Court for staying the trial proceedings of another four sabotage cases filed in different police stations, including Darussalam, against BNP chairperson Begum Khalida Zia. A five-member bench of the Virtual Appellate Division, headed by Chief Justice Syed Mahmood Hussain, passed the order on Sunday after the hearing of the state's appeal. At the same time, the court asked the High Court to dispose of the rule issued on the question of quashing the order to take cognizance of the allegations in those four cases. However, the Appellate Division did not mention the date of disposal of the rule. Attorney General Mahbub-e Alam stood for the state, while Barrister A.M. Mahbubuddin Kokon represented Khalida Zia. The court has formed charges against the expelled leader of the Jubo Mohila League, Shamima Noor Bapia, and her husband, Mofizur Rahman, alias Shuman Chaudhary, in an arms case. Their trial officially started today with the formation of this allegation. Judge K.M. Imrul Kayesh of the Dhaka Metropolitan Session Judges Court passed the order at 12 noon. 12 people were made witnesses in the charge sheet of the case. The court has fixed August 31st to September 3rd for taking testimonies. Bangladeshi workers who went to work in Japan completely free of cost returned with good news even amid the corona crisis. According to the agreement with the Japanese government, in addition to the monthly salary of taka 1.5 lakh, they returned to the country and received a check of around taka 5 lakh. Expatriate Welfare Minister and Member of Parliament Imran Ahmed handed over the check to them on Sunday. At the same time, the minister said over 78,000 workers were forced to return to the country in the last 5 months. Imran stated that the government is planning to employ the returnee workers from Japan in our country after their internship. Indian High Commissioner to Dhaka Reeva Ganguly paid a courtesy call on Agriculture Minister Abdul Razak at the Secretariat this afternoon. At the same time, they said 50 years of bilateral relations would be completed between neighboring Bangladesh and India. Moreover, 50 years of liberation war and independence of Bangladesh would also be completed in 2021. The two countries are working to enhance bilateral cooperations on the occasion of Mujib Borsho. At the same time, the minister said there are many opportunities for cooperation between the two countries in the agricultural sector. Bangladesh has registered 34 new fatalities from COVID-19 in a daily count, taking the death toll to 3,941. The tally of infections climbed to 294,598 after 1,973 people tested positive for COVID-19 in the 24 hours to 8 a.m. Sunday, according to data released by the Health Directorate. The total number of deaths in the world has exceeded 8 lakh, with more than 5,300 deaths in 24 hours. More than 2,33,000 people have been infected worldwide in one day. New infections are on the rise in several countries. The total infected in the world is 2,34,02,000. The World Health Organization, who made it mandatory for children over the age of 12 to wear face masks. Meanwhile, Britain's top scientific advisor has warned that the deadly coronavirus will remain in the world forever in one form or another. Meanwhile, Russia has claimed success in another trial vaccine called Epivac Corona after the Sputnik V vaccine. A third phase trial of the vaccine is underway at the country's Vector State Research Center of Virology and Biotechnology. Furthermore, according to Serum Institute, a corona vaccine manufacturer in India, the people of the country would get free corona vaccine within the next 73 days if everything goes according to plan. German giants Bayern Munich and French champions Paris Saint-Germain will face each other in the final of the UEFA Champions League tonight. The match would start at the Luz Stadium in Lisbon at 1 p.m. Bangladesh time. In addition to winning the Champions League for the sixth time, the Bavarians have a chance to win the treble for the second time. On the other hand, the French giants, who have been eliminated from the quarterfinals 7 times, are hoping to make new history. That's all the news for today. Thank you for watching News 24. Please stay with us.